So I had this crazy idea a few years ago, because as a teacher, it's very frustrating sometimes with the lack of hands-on skill that our next generation has with handling tools and knowing how to eventually use them in a creative way, productive, practical way. So now we have woodworking camp here at the Art Center, and it allows us to teach them the proper use of all kinds of hand tools, woodworking tools, so they can build things, so they can take their crazy thoughts and imagination and put it into a product that they can keep forever, maybe even hand them down to their next generation. So in woodworking summer camp, they're using coping saw, hand saws, hand drills, sandpaper, files, rulers, so it's great to reinforce their math concepts as well. When you're finally, come closer so you can see, okay? Okay, you want to make sure you're getting your flat side nice and smooth. Also, angle it so that you're really getting your corners finished off. They have the creative component, so if we're doing something practical like building a chair, they have the creative part to what they're turning their chair into. So if it's their backboard, maybe it's a cat. We had space shuttles, rocket ships, Pac-Man. It's been a great balance of learning the practical in a monitored, really fun way. And they'll have these skills forever. So, and they get the creativity of designing their boards to their characters and personalities. So I would like you to be able to take this masterpiece home with you tomorrow so that you don't have to carry it the same day as your board. So if you wanted to add any paint, great, but it really doesn't, because guys, one of the things I love about working with wood, look at all the subtle changes in color, right, from the different types of wood, from the light tans, almost cream color, to the more brown colors. Personally, I don't think you should put any color unless you really have a vision that it is colorful and like a candy land or something. But if you're happy with it, plain wood. I'm also happy with the plain wood.
I was trying to make a normal starfish, and then I managed to turn it into this shooting star somehow. This is a coping saw. You use it to cut circles and all that stuff. As you can obviously tell, you see the Big Dipper over here. Oh, there's also, I tried drawing part of a supernova explosion here. And then this was a shooting star until by its trail. And these are just regular stars dotted around yellow and white.
I chose the star stencil because that's really what I connected to most. I first put I traced stars on a piece of wax paper, and then it went down onto the wood, and I colored the stars in and it put wood stain on top, which was pretty fun. Never really worked with wood stain. The other parts that are black are with the acrylic paint. I used the saws to cut the star out over here. I had to cut part of the seat out with a straight saw because it was too long.
My name is Kylie, and designing my turtle is very nice. I chose it because I have a turtle at home and I thought she'll really like it. I traced it out of a utensil and colored it green with a nice pattern on the back. And I like this one so much because I used a very beautiful ocean design and really different colors of blending. And the chair is very comfortable.